Yo, what's up? It's Music by Lucas here. I'm a music producer and DJ, and today I want to talk about what to do in those moments where you're in the studio and you have no inspiration to make a track. I usually just drink coffee. That's actually way too hot. Get weird with your samples. So go to Splice or whatever website you use, similar to Splice, and do a blank search. And instead of going under things you would normally look up like kicks, claps, fills, vocals, stuff like that, try to search for weird things by using the hashtags and the genres. So use hashtags like atmospheric, tonal, textures, effects, and use genres like cinematic, grime, synthwave, chiptune, something like that, something different and unique, and just see what comes up, because sometimes just hearing an interesting sound or an interesting sample can spark a lot of inspiration. Don't start from zero. So open up one of your old tracks that you really liked, something that you did well, and save as, and then just delete the MIDI, delete the vocal, and keep the drums, the effects, basically the framework, because sometimes that's what will get you started moving in the right direction, is not having to do all that original framework. If you have something to get you started, it'll push you in the right direction. Tweak your MIDI files. So if you have a melody that you made, again, something you made before that was really good, that you like the pattern or something, or maybe you have an FLP or some other kind of file, or you downloaded like a sound bank and you have some MIDI files, whatever, you can use that as a framework as well, and just mess around with the notes. Just move things around until it sounds completely different, or just different than the original MIDI. Because your goal, of course, is not to copy, but sometimes it's really hard, like if you open up the piano roll, or if you're sitting at the piano, to come up with something, you're just drawing a blank. So having that framework there can really help get that inspiration going. Let your creativity flow naturally. So sometimes when I'm in the studio, I'm just like wanting to make the best track ever, like right from the start. I'm like, today I'm gonna make something completely interesting, completely unique, you know, it's gonna be my best one yet. And that can cause a lot of pressure on yourself, and you don't really let the creativity flow. You're just like judging every single idea that you come up with, and eventually what can happen is you run out of ideas. Like, let's say you're trying to come up with a melody, no melody is good enough, you run out of ideas, and you end up leaving the studio frustrated, feeling like your session was a complete waste of time. Instead, if you go into the studio and just kind of like not have those crazy expectations and just let things happen as they happen, that can lead to a really cool track or a really cool thing. And that's actually how I came up with my future trance style, is I stopped like thinking, I gotta make a Hexagon track, or I gotta make a Future House Music track, like I have to make a track like Sagan or Don Diablo, I have to have those kind of melodies. Like, I kind of just went to the studio and just decided I'm gonna do whatever comes naturally and see what happens. And what ended up happening was I created a mixture between Future House and trance music, and I really like what came out of it. Get detailed feedback on your new or old tracks from skilled producers. So a lot of times, you know, other people are gonna see things that you don't, because you're focused on one thing, but they're coming at a track, you know, hearing it for the first time, completely new set of ears, and they focus on things that you didn't hear when you were listening to it. So that can be really helpful, but make sure you're getting feedback from skilled producers. You don't want to just get general feedback like the mix needs work, because that's not really going to help inspire you. You need someone that's going to be like, you should try this maybe. Maybe this could be a cool idea. And then you're like, huh, maybe that is interesting. You may not know where to find producers to get that kind of feedback. So the online music school can be super helpful for that, because of course you can work with me anytime on your tracks via email or voice message, but you can also get feedback from the other members on the team. Many of them signed who are doing really good stuff, and they can give you great successful tips as well. Collab. Okay, so I say this a lot, but if there's something you are not particularly skilled at that frustrates you and potentially leads you to have no inspiration, like maybe you're not good at making melodies or breaks or drops or just something in particular, some kind of mixing or mastering, whatever, find someone else to collab with who is good at those things, so you can focus on the things you like doing, because you'll be more inspired to do those things anyway. Plus, as an added bonus, you can maybe learn how to do the things that you're not good at from that other producer. Maybe you have a Skype session or something like that. They can show you their technique or their process, and all of a sudden, you know, you feel more confident because you know how to do it better, and the inspiration starts rolling. And this one sounds really simple, but sometimes you just need to take a break. As the saying goes, absence makes the heart grow fonder. And in my experience, if I take a few days off, or maybe even more time off, I start to feel that itch to get back into the studio and produce again. And when I do get back into the studio, I'm producing better, I'm faster, I'm coming up with more unique ideas, because it's almost like pent up energy that I'm ready to like unleash, you know, and come up with a bunch of new ideas. And if you have any more tips on what helps you when you're lacking inspiration, be sure to comment those below. Also, for the first time this entire year, we are launching a sale, special sale, on our online music school membership. So you can check that out and all of our holiday offers at teammbl.com/sale. And don't forget to like, subscribe, hit the notifications. Do it for Lauren, not for me.
Yes, that's right.
You're gonna break her heart. She's not gonna do the feedback video. She's gonna listen to your guys' tracks soon, actually, so make sure to leave those thumbs up so she feels excited to listen to your tracks. Should we do that for Christmas or something? What do you think? She's saying cut the video.